Kes weja.
Kes ke serbas?
Où et moi, Amsta?
Excusez-moi.
Ja a grand soif pour la connaissance.
Buena, and welcome back from your Veterans Day holiday. It is Friday, November 12th, and I'm Jackie Barnes here with
Blake Diamond. Starting off this morning's broadcast is sports. Last week, the Colts lost to South Point with a final score of 28-13. In light of this loss, Buena will square off against Flowing Wells tonight in the final game of the season. So get out there and support your team. For more on sports, we go to KBHS's Gabe Garcia.
Okay, I'm here with Miles. Miles, how do you think we're going to do against South Point and Flowing Wells?
Well, I think we're going to kill them. You know, we struggled a little bit, but other than that, we're going to do pretty good.
What do you think will be the key points?
What'd you say?
What do you think will be the key points?
Basically, just doing your job. Make sure you do your responsibilities, then we'll be all right.
Thanks. Javaris, how do you think we're going to do on Friday and Friday after that?
I think we're going to do pretty good. We've been in practice all week, working hard, so I think we're going to end up winning the last two games.
What do you think will be the key points?
Well, we get Simone back on offense, starting offense, we might do something. Move the ball, you know what I'm saying, pass the ball more, we might be good to go.
Thanks. Okay, I'm here with Coach Schaefer. How do you think we're going to do against South Point and Flying Wells?
I think our chances against South Point and Flying Wells are very good. Our defense is playing very well right now. And as long as we hang on to the ball and take care of the ball and run the ball very well, we should beat both Caballeros and the Lancers.
What do you think will be the key points of winning both games?
Ball control by our offense, the running game, and then also throw a little pass in every now and again, and a good, strong defensive effort by everybody that plays.
Okay, thank you, Coach. I'm here with Coach Evans. Coach, how do you think we'll do against South Point and Flowing Wells?
I think we can beat both of them. Neither of them are as good a team as Sabino or Amphitheater. And we've been playing well lately. We just haven't been scoring points, but I think we're going to make some adjustments to take care of that, and we should be able to beat both of them.
What do you think will be the key points?
How our offense does, and that we not make mistakes and fumble the ball and have penalties at critical times, because if we do that, I know we'll put the ball in the end zone, and if we score, we'll definitely win.
Okay, thank you, Coach.
In addition to football, other sports are winding down as well. Tryouts for winter sports are on the way.
Today and tomorrow is the Pride and Prejudice Jane Austen Festival. Miss Mohead's class has gotten into the spirit of the festival and has made some botanical prints, which were favored in the time that the play is set in. The festival starts at 6:30, and the play begins right after at 7:30. Admission is $4.
So, Jackie, have you been in the new mall yet?
Yeah, I think everyone has.
Well, we sent out a correspondent to see what people thought of the mall. And here's what they had to say.
I'm Millie Garcia, reporter for KBHS TV3. Today we are here at the new mall of Sara Vista, which has been under construction for some time now. 2 to 3 weeks ago, it has opened. We are here to interview some customers, workers, and the general manager to see what they have to say about the new mall.
Have you ever been tired of having to drive from one store to another, trying to find the item you're looking for? Well, now you can just drive to the mall and everything is just in one place. It has a variety of stores to shop at and find what you need. According to the general manager, it took 25 years to build this mall, and now we finally have one. So if you're in need of some clothes, jewelry, household accessories, or just want a place to hang out, come visit our mall.
Blakemore.
Rosetta Sylvester.
And what would you do to improve the mall?
I would add some more clothing stores for plus size women.
I would make it bigger so you can just roam more stuff to look at.
What is about the mall that you like?
They tried hard to give a variety, so I'll give them that much.
I like the food court the best.
Do you think it'll do good in services since it's so small?
Yeah, I think it should do pretty well, give us the stores to shop at.
Yeah, it looks good, gives everybody something different to do, some place to hang out, place to go.
Do you like working here and why?
I enjoy my job a lot. Get to meet new people, interesting people like you guys here.
Do you think it'll do good in Sierra Vista? Why?
The mall will do really well here in Sierra Vista. We already are here at Sears are seeing some huge increases. We also pull a lot of traffic from the outlying areas in Mexico.
Do you think it was worth building a mall in Sierra Vista since it was so small?
Yes, this is a great plus for Sierra Vista as a whole, because again, we do pull from so many other areas, and I think we'll start taking a lot of customers away from going to Tucson.
Do you like working here? Why?
I don't know, probably all the people. I like working with people.
Exactly.
And Regina.
Yeah. Do you think it was a good idea to build the mall, and why?
Yeah, we definitely needed one. I don't like traveling to Tucson or Phoenix. I don't think anyone else does, so I think we really did need one.
Well, you heard it. The mall is a great place to shop. From the Moon Mall of Sierra Vista, I'm Millie Garcia, KBHS TV3.
The mall isn't the only new thing going on at Sierra Vista. Karchner Caverns was recently opened to the public. Our own Buena's Color Guard will be present at the grand opening.
Well, we're going to be back for a short break from these words from our sponsors.
For 60 cents! You'll be alright. Next time, go to the snack shack. They won't take your money. I wish I would have known it before.
It's stuck!
Your food won't get stuck at the snack shack either. Let's go over there. Okay. Hey guys, check out the snack shack. Isn't it great?
Yeah!
You know the student store is better than machines because there's fast, friendly service, and you'll never get your food stuck or money taken. And if that wasn't enough, there's hot, fresh food and soda and candy all in one place. And it's conveniently open during all three lunches. So just remember, when you think Snack Shack.
Welcome back to our show. Watch for Otis Funkemeyer cookies sold every Monday and Tuesday during all three lunches in front of the Snack Shack. Cookies are baked fresh. Nicole Dix was elected Skills USA Vicar Regional Reporter and recently came close to a chance to become state reporter while at the state officers' camp. We're proud of you for trying, Nicole. Also, Megan Markham won the position of Regional Treasurer.
National Honor Society inaugurated new members last Tuesday. NHS recognizes outstanding academic performance as well as leadership, skills, and attitude. Congratulations to the new members.
Do you have a problem concerning school or perhaps with your life that you'd like to talk to someone about? PSG, or Peer Support Group, is available for you. If you wish to speak with a member, please feel free to sign up for an appointment in the counselor's office.
Not many people at Buena know what our dance class is about. We sent out Monica Avalos, a student of the class, to find out for us.
Monica reporting for KBHS TV3. We're here at the dance class to show and tell you some of the things that happen in this class. A lot of people think that in dance class we strut around in a little tutu doing ballet. I don't think so. Come on and let's show you what they do in dance class.
The dance class is not easy, but it's a lot of fun. If dancing is one of your hobbies, you definitely have to get into this class. You have to learn to be disciplined and a little creative too. We asked some of the students how they feel about being in dance class.
I really enjoy it because it gives me a chance to work out and still have fun doing it.
It's a nice break from like all 5 hours of just classwork. You can go to dance, have fun, and goof around.
We get to dance what we want to dance. We dance everything, so. And Mr. Jar is a lot of fun, and we get to be with our friends, so.
We get to be really creative, and it's just a break from sitting down all day in school, and it's a lot of fun. I love the people in there. We have a great time.
This semester, the advanced class has been busy working on a hip-hop chair dance. All the students seem to like this dance the best. They also have been doing a lyrical, which takes a lot of grace, balance, and concentration. This one was a little bit harder for the girls to learn, but they seem to be getting the hang of it. The intro class has been learning a hip-hop dance to Backstreet Boys. They all seem to be doing great, considering the fact they're newcomers. Who knows, maybe next year they'll be in advanced class.
After seeing all this, do you think the dance class is difficult? We asked Miss Ajar, the dance instructor, how she feels about this.
No, I don't think so. I think of all the people in dance class, there's only a few who've taken dance before. The majority have never taken dance. All you have to do is come to class with an energy and willing to learn the dances.
So that's what we do in our dance class. I hope to see you all at our upcoming show on December 8th at 7 o'clock. This is Monica signing off for KBHS TV3.
We would like to thank the Snack Shack for sponsoring our show this morning. We would also like to apologize to the choir for not reporting their performance on October 26th, but we do have some highlights of their concert for those who missed it.
Is overcrowding a problem here at Buena? Tamara Only and Levi Crane report on who thinks there is and who doesn't.
This is Tamara reporting for KBHS TV3, and recently we checked out some serious issue Buena has. One existing problem being overcrowding throughout the whole school. Classrooms are filled to capacity, hallways are always full no matter what bell or where everyone is supposed to be. We caught up with some students and teachers and asked them how overcrowding affects them and in what ways. Here's what they had to say.
How do you feel about the overcrowding at Buena?
I don't like it. I just feel they should open up a new school.
When you walk through the halls, you're trying to push through people who, taking their time to get to their classes, people who stop in the middle of the halls to just talk to their friends, and, it gets really hectic, and you don't want to have to deal with it sometimes.
Yeah, I think if we had less people, we would have less problems.
Buena actually, as of a couple of years ago, we increased the time going to classes from 5 minutes to 6, and I think that's helped a little bit. And one suggestion that I think would help, if students walk on the right side of the hallways, that would help. And also, during passing periods, if they would scoot to the side so they don't clog up the top of the ramp. I think if everybody cooperates, it'll be okay.
It's too crowded. It's too crowded.
What disciplinary problems are created because of overcrowding in classrooms then?
I think two problems probably. The first one is obviously if you have X number of students above what you feel you should have, which is 30, then that's more students for the teacher to observe and watch and keep track of. At the same time, it's more difficult maybe to teach the class.
And it's hard to get through the hallways because there's so many people and because the school is overcrowded. And then I get to my class late and I get marked down for being tardy when it's not even my fault. And I get a task, too, when I get 4 tardies, and that's happened once so far this school year.
It depends on who you speak to as far as what is the limit to the school. My perception is 2,600, give or take a few here and there. So I generally think about 2,600 as the school can hold more. If you get every classroom, 30 students in every classroom that is a regular classroom, then how many you have is probably more than 2,600. But we can all see in the hallways that it's still pretty jammed right now, so I'd say about 2,600. We have just at 2,600 enrolled right now, about 2,605.
We do our best to accommodate everybody. It's a lot of folks under one roof, that's understood. There's no quick solution to that since we only have one school. I think the biggest thing is just common courtesy.
The more students you have in a classroom, the less individual attention you can give, so that's the problem it poses right there, I think.
There are things service as a community and Buena as a school could do for this problem, but here at KBHS we don't have the answers. But if you have something to say, speak out. Someone's got to be listening. This is Tamara Only for KBHS TV3.
For all the photographers out there, here's a contest for you. The ASBA Jack Peterson Photo Contest. Entries must be an 8x10 print of an Arizona landscape. It must have been taken within the last 12 months. If you're interested, mail your entries to ASBA 2100 North Central Avenue, Suite 200, Phoenix, Arizona, 85004. All entries must be received by November 19th.
On the subject of contests, there is an upcoming No Tardies Pizza Party contest starting towards the end of this month and will run for 2 weeks. The office will keep track of classes with a no tardy record, and at the end of the 2 weeks, the top 10 classes will receive a pizza party.
We would like to thank Michelle Gregorio's commercial art class for continuing work on creating a mural and logo for our newscast. Thanks, guys. Also, we would like to remind our viewers of our response boxes. You can use them to tell us what you think of our show. We enjoy any feedback you may have for us and welcome any ideas you may have for the show. The boxes are located in the library, student services, and room 1101.
Well, that concludes our broadcast for today. We hope you tune in next time on December 3rd. Until then, I'm Blake Diamond.
And I'm Jackie Barnes. Have a nice day.